My name is Shubham Chokse.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Jaspreet Singh.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Jaspreet Singh.
And we are from the river
Jhelum. So, how many of you can live without internet? I don't see any hands up. Oh, some of them are coming up. Well, please don't joke. You can't, I know that. All right, so we have a video in store for you. Let's have the video, please.
यारों को यारी फरमाने दो दोस्ती की सब बातें गुफ्तगू में चलने दो कुछ शरारते किस्से खुल के आज कहने दो चुप चुप गप शप क्यों हो जाने दो
Get incredibly fast downloads. AIRCEL Pocket Internet 3G. AIRCEL.
Thank you.
So did you like the video? Okay, so as you can see in today's presentation, we will be taking you through a case study on AIRCEL, how it emerged as a market leader in the mobile network telecom industry in India, how it fell down. So over to you, Shubham.
Why we chose this slide?
Sure. Can we have the next slide, please?
Next. So in the next few minutes, we will be going through the rise and fall of AIRCEL Limited. These will be the contents which we will be presenting. Next.
And the reason that we chose this slide is because AIRCEL was once a market leader. It provided unlimited 2G internet in mobile phones and it failed. So let's go ahead. The next slide, please.
The company name AIRCEL Limited, founded in the year 1999 in Coimbatore, Tamil Nadu by Chinnakannan Sivasankaran. If anyone of who doesn't know him, let's have a pic of him. Yeah. Sorry, picture of him. This is the person, the great personality, which founded AIRCEL Limited.
And yes, it was founded in Chennai in Tamil Nadu. And it was jointly owned by Maxis Communications of Malaysia and Apollo Hospitals through Scindia Investments and Securities. And Maxis Communications had a 74% stake and Scindia had 26% stake in the organization. So can we have the next slide, please? Now, AIRCEL at a glance. So AIRCEL emerged as the market leader in southern India within a decade of commencement of its operations.
AIRCEL also emerged as the market leader in the Assam and northeastern states within 18 months of its launch in those states.
And do you know that it is credited with the fastest 3G rollout in the Indian telecom market? It covered about 13 circles at that time.
And it's mainly targeted youth.
And how many do you know about pocket internet? Okay, so around the year 2010, AIRCEL was the only organization which provided unlimited internet in mobile phone. They had a rupees 98 plan through which they provided unlimited internet. Can we have the next slide, please? Okay, so how AIRCEL grew over time. So before 2006, AIRCEL was only owned by its founder. And by the end of 2005, Maxis Communications had acquired a 74% stake in this organization. So that is how they owned the company almost.
In the year 2010, AIRCEL paid rupees 7,900 crores for the 3G spectrum. By the year 2012, the company had about 50 lakh 3G customers. In 2014, they launched the first 4G service in India and they became the first private telecom partner to provide all the 3G services, namely 2G, 3G and 4G.
And do you know what happened in 2016 in the telecom market? Anyone?
Audio.
Well, that is correct. Jio came into picture. And when Jio came, all the telecom operators were literally trying to save themselves. So most of them tried to merge with each other. So even Aircel made an attempt to merge with Reliance Communications. And let's have the next slide, please.
No, next slide.
Can we have the next slide, please? So taking you to the market size of Aircel, as you can see that in the ocean of mobile network operators, Aircel was a comparatively small fish because the big fishes were Vodafone, Airtel, Reliance, Jio and Idea. So Aircel was still competing with all of them. Can we have the next slide, please?
As Jaspreet told about the competitors, by the year 2017, there were total 117 crore subscribers, out of which Aircel consisted of only 8.5 crores. And the leading competitors were Airtel, Vodafone, Idea, Jio, and BSNL.
Okay, so how many of you know about corporate social responsibility? Does it ring a bell? Okay, so for those of you who don't know, organizations which make lump sums of money, they have some sort of responsibility towards the society. So that is where CSR comes into play. So this is how Aircel played its part. They had a collaboration with NDTV and they launched Save the Tigers campaign. They also helped in Mumbai floods, of course. So let's take a look at that as well. Image two, please. So here you can see how they also made an attempt to market themselves. They had a boat in Mumbai floods. Can we have the next one, please? It was taken away, not stolen. Next one, please. Next, please. And yes, that is how we play corporate social responsibility. Can we have the slides, please? Now coming over to the marketing of Aircel, they have brand ambassadors such as our Captain Cool, Mahindra Singh Dhoni, for all India level. They also have a brand ambassador for targeting their southern market, that is our Tollywood superstar Surya.
The other marketing strategies that they took were they sponsored IPL team, that is CSK, and they also sponsored Indian Football League and various local sports. Apart from that, in 2011, when Apple iPhone 4 was launched, it was the launch partner with Bharti Airtel.
Now, let's take a look at the analysis. What are the strengths, weaknesses, opportunities and threats that they have faced? So coming over to strengths.
Strengths, it had a strong presence in Tamil Nadu and northeastern states. Along with that, they were having a good advertising and marketing strategies.
So coming over to their weaknesses, what they had was they were, after the Jio disruption, they were unable to merge with any of the telecom providers. They were also unable to come into spectrum sharing deals with them. And they were also unable to secure investments from one of their largest investment provider, that was Maxis Communications. So coming over to the opportunities.
The opportunities that they had, that at that time they had a power, or we can say they can grasp the Indian telecom market with the latest and the low cost technologies that they were introducing.
So the threats that they faced were mostly, of course, from Jio, and also they had reached a saturation point in the telephony market by the year 2015. They were very good in providing mobile number portability services, but that also worked against them. Now,
the findings, firstly, in the starting of the Aircel, they provided a good quality network and the services, but gradually the service decreased. They offered a poor network. Then they were using ancient radio link technology, which causes the increase in the rate of call drop.
And now coming to the conclusion, of course, Aircel had faced a lot of challenges as they were unable to arrange investments, unable to merge with any of them, and unable to enter into spectrum sharing deals, unable to pay dues, and hence they went bankrupt at last and they had to close their operations in February 2018. Thank you.
Thank you.